Welcome to prayer and announcements for Thursday, May the 28th. Let's begin by praying together the act of love.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. O my God, I love you above all things with my whole heart and soul, because you are all good and worthy of all my love. I love my neighbor as myself for the love of you. I forgive all who have injured me, and ask pardon of all whom I have injured. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Hey everyone, welcome to your announcements for Thursday, May 28th. Hopefully by now you've all had a chance to watch yesterday's video about the return to school on Monday, June the 1st. It was a lot of fun to make, and although it looks strange seeing people separated by 2 meters and fewer desks in the classroom and having to play with a little bit of distance, I want everyone to know that it's gonna be all right. For those of you coming to school, we're gonna make the most of it. And for those of you staying home, keep working hard and learning. As a refresher, here's the schedule for next week. On Monday, June the 1st, students will begin school at 8:50 a.m. if they're coming to school that day. Classes will end at 3 p.m. The same schedule will be followed on Tuesday, June the 2nd. Wednesday through Friday, there will be no regular classes at school, but the children of essential service workers will be having classes at school. Of course, since there will be fewer numbers, the classes will have to be arranged differently, but we'll make the most of it and we'll try to have fun while we have a smaller group of students to work with. The schedule for week 2, which begins on June the 8th, is yet to be determined. Families who change their mind and decide to come to school after week 1 have until the Wednesday, June the 3rd to let us know, and then we'll plan our second week. If we get enough students, we might schedule more days of classes. So let us know by Wednesday, June the 3rd, if you're hoping to come for the second week of the return to school. Time for birthdays and your joke of the day. Big birthday to Hayden today. Hope you're having a good one and look forward to seeing you next week. And your joke of the day, Hayden, you like this one. What do you call a bear without an ear? Boo. And that's your joke of the day. Well, that's all for now. We're going to end today's announcements with a video from Ethan in grade 5, who's going to teach us how to make a Roblox game. I don't know what that is, but it sounds super cool. Have a safe and active day. And remember, God made you special, and he loves you very much.
Making games on Roblox by Ethan. Exclusive. Ain't no just putting models around. Make your own models by going to the home menu, going to insert part, and make your own models. Mess around with the scale and rotate tools. You can also change the material and color. Well, if it's too hard, then you can just resort to modeling. I don't care what you do, I'm not going to discourage you. Codes. You can create your own game on Roblox, but it's not easy. There might be a virus. Variables. Stores information. Functions. Practically a loop. You need the game to be interesting. Tip. Get some plugins. It'll make it so much easier. I got some, and it was so easy. Your game should have action. We're not playing Sitting Simulator, are we? Tip. People like something that has levels and XP in it. Also a trading menu and pets. Adopt Me has a lot of visits and views because of the pet trading. Plugins can save a lot of time and coding. Well, I put a video over there that can teach you about plugins. You can go see it for yourself after this presentation. Hyped? So am I. Go make yourself a Roblox account first. I'll give you the link. Type the URL in the search engine once you get to Google. Know how? Book a Zoom meeting with me. I'll teach you how to. You're finally ready. Go to Roblox Studio and yeah, because you learned everything. Link you should type in if you want to make a game. Go to the search engine and type that URL in. Thanks. Remember, don't spend too much time on Roblox. Make sure to take a break from staring at the computer screen. Anyone want me to teach them for a little bit? I'll book a Zoom meeting. Only for grade 4 or 5 people, because I have contact for them. I will tell them in a class meeting. Woohoo! If you made it this far, I will give you some B-Bucks or Robux. Thank you for watching. I would put an outro, but I'm too lazy.